Normally, only with head movement does fluid within the inner ear also move, informing the brain that a head turn occurred. However, should a crystal called an otolith gets displaced into the posterior canal of the inner ear, BPPV dizziness occurs. Fluid movement occurs due to the crystal rather than head turns, causing the brain to think movement has occurred even though none has happened. When the half-somersault maneuver is performed to treat posterior canal BPPV, the loose crystal is attempted to be removed out of the canal with a specific sequence of head movements. This maneuver is started by kneeling. While kneeling, the head is quickly tipped upward and back. The somersault position is then assumed, with the chin tucked as far as possible toward the knee. The head is then turned towards the affected ear 45 degrees, so that the nose is pointing at the elbow. This position is maintained for 30 to 60 seconds. If BPPV is present, a rhythmic eye twitch called nystagmus will occur. While keeping the head turned at 45 degrees, the head is then raised to be aligned with the shoulder. This position is maintained for 30 to 60 seconds. While keeping the head turned at 45 degrees, the head is then raised to the fully upright position. At this point, the maneuver is completed, and the patient can sit back up. Keep in mind that with each position change, dizziness may recur and is perfectly normal. So what's going on with these position changes? Essentially, the head has moved in such a way to manipulate the crystal to fall towards the canal opening. With each position change, it takes about 30 to 60 seconds for the crystal to settle into the most dependent position in the canal. If turns are made before the crystal has a chance to settle, the crystal may fall back the wrong way, and the maneuver will fail. It is also important that the head positions are angled correctly, or else the crystal will not settle to the correct position in the canal, and the maneuver will fail. Also, if the position changes are done too slowly, the crystal may not settle quickly enough from lack of momentum, and the maneuver will also fail. Once the crystal falls out of the canal, the dizziness should resolve if due to posterior canal BPPV. If done correctly and successfully, doing this maneuver only once will cure BPPV 80% of the time, and repeated maneuvers will not be necessary.